Good day. Okay, this time we're going to be showing you our newest creation for Metrosimulator, the Paris MF67 train. This train was created by a cooperation between former username HexxOP and myself, and is now almost ready for release. As we don't have a Paris route at the moment, let's take it for a spin on our London network, or as it is called in the Metro Simulator world, the City of Thames. Okay, let's get our passengers in. And of course, let's board ourselves. Ah, you already have a green light, so let's go. Okay, let's send it for automatic for a moment so we can explore the passengers compartment. Station Eastminster. Thank you. keep in mind the speed signals on the side of the track are in miles per hour, while this train drives in kilometers an hour. So that's why I'll be overspeeding in relation to the side. I know a faster red signal there. How about we switch routes? Let me show you one of the other versions of this track. Okay, from the MF67 2012 variant, we now go to the MF67 1976 variant, and we're going to do that on the Simfleet 1982 map. First, let's take a look of our train on the outside. Service 201 to Simplit Centrum. But perhaps it would be nicer to use a French destination instead. Centreville, or city center. And let some passengers aboard our train. As you see, this variant of the train doesn't only look different from the outside, it also has a different interior. And, of course, as was usual in Paris in the time, a first class coach in the middle of the train. If you already have a green light, let's go! Closing the door. Now a little bit on the handle on the left, we have here. This is the train protection selector handle. We have a four setting for this. At the moment it is in ATB sub, which is used for the train protection system on the Simfleet and Rijndam networks. With the ANS keys we can select which one we want. When we set it to neutre, we are driving with all train protection systems off, and in this case, on the outside of our train, the two yellow lights next to the destination display will be lit. In the simulator, this then will mean that this train is running without train protection active. We can also set it to code manual. This is for use when you drive this train on the central line route. This also came out recently. This is in effect just the same as ATB with just a few modifications to it. And as last, also for use on the central line, but also usable when driving on the ATB is the ATO setting or automatic train operation. In this setting, the traction handle will be fixed in the zero position as you are not driving the train, the computer is, and the door side selector handle on the right will be set to automatic instead of left or right. Okay, let's drive in ATO setting the next session. This train now passing us on the left side was the 1967 version of this train, which features some different colors on the outside and a yellow first class carriage in the middle. Just as the doors opened, you saw a little red indicator flash next to the door's open symbol. This happens because this train, it's possible to open the doors when the speed is below 2.5 km/h. So when the train stops and the doors are opened, this can happen while the train is still moving. The red symbol that just flashes just shows the doors are open while the train is not at the good spot. Okay, well, this train continues on its way. We'll just go look at one other iteration of this train. So this is the MP73 variant. The material 1973 compares on rubber tires instead of the normal metal wheels. Of course, the normal wheels are still present in between, but mainly for guidance in switches. The horizontal and vertical wheels are what's guiding the train. Let's see it as one of the trains is coming in. As this train runs on rubber tires, the acceleration is also a bit faster than on the metal-on-metal MF67. So here the metal wheels guide the train in the extra right direction of the distance. Other than that, the rubber tires will provide our guidance. Okay, let's get back to our plane for a moment. as you see, there is quite some more room of platform left. That's because the platforms in this network are 135 meters long, made for three sets of Rotterdam SK3 planes. But the Paris 5-car trains are only 75 meters long. So, in theory, if you want to train as long as the platforms, you can use a 5-car and a 3-car train top of the pillar, even though that would never happen in German Paris. Okay, the last train for this video, the Convoy Doté, the work train of the Paris Metro. This train is also based on the MF67. Let's take a look at the train first. We'll be testing it on the Rijndam Museum line. If you want to know where we are here. The outer coaches are just the standard vehicles. Let me open the doors for you. These have some trash containers in them. The middle cars are for transporting some heavier goods. One is empty, do it as you like, and one has some goods in it to show you how the real one might be filled. These side doors are also animated. With Shift X, I can open the curtain and then Ctrl X to lower these side hatches. And now you have a safe way to transport all the goods on and off the train at every platform. Now, to close it up again, Ctrl X to close the hatches. And Shift X to close the curtain. Now, then let's take it for a drive for a moment. Let's set the path. W42907. Oh, and my door's still closed. Luckily they had no passengers. These trains are downloadable now on the wiki page, and as always, thanks for watching.